It is the most dangerous secret weapon in the world. Cyclone, the ultimate weapon on two wheels. A genius created it.
Brick was involved in a very important military project.
Everyone's after it.
I'm told you have something I want.
Only one woman controls it. Cyclone. Starring Heather Thomas and Martin Landau. Cyclone. Prepare for the ride of your life. It'll blow you away.
No!
Cyclone. The ultimate team of woman and machine.
Take a desperate man.
You want to put me in jail? You want to put me in jail? Go right ahead, because I could use a break.
Give him the chance of a lifetime.
All you have to do to collect a big fat commission is go over there, get a signature, and collect the premium.
In the most dangerous place in town.
I'm going to tell you something, Sonny. I've had a very long day, and I have neither the time nor the patience for any more of you kids playing Scarface with me.
Get back, man.
We got us a war zone here. Vampires.
What do you see?
Moon.
What kind of moon?
Moon.
This is our night. Our castle. What's out there for us? Show me your face.
This is their territory.
Do the vampires do this?
And here, no one gets out alive.
Floor, room by room, closet by closet. Anybody won't let you in, you close the door. Cut them, burn them, whatever it takes.
There's a war going on out there, man.
They're alone. 20 floors up. And the only way out is down.
Shoot him.
Torello's law.
Who the hell are you? Listen to me, you
big dummy. I'm a cop. Get out of camp. Get out of camp!
Why? Who killed Connelly?
Why?
Who killed him?
I don't know!
Punk!
If you hurt anybody else, when this is over, I'm going to find what you love the most, and I'm going to kill it. Your mother, your father, your dog. It don't matter what it is. It's dead.
This is his story.
You should have taken them cops out! You gotta do
whatever you gotta do! You wanna understand that? Torello's Law.
When I take you down, I'm gonna take you down right. I'm gonna take you down all the way.
Torello's Story. Crime Story, the style of the 60s, the power of the 80s.
He was an orphan, left to perish in the downtown wilderness.
Hey, you! Hey, hey!
Instead, thrived.
They say it can turn itself into an alley cat.
He became a hunter.
It's a half-human creature that hunts his own.
A warrior.
Now, winos around here swear up and down that they've seen it.
A legend of the city. Wild thing. She has seen him.
Why did you let me see you?
I was lonely.
Now, he is her only hope. A new breed of hero.
Wild Thing.
Wild Thing.
Bringing you another World's Eye View of championship boxing at its very best. There's the bell for round one, and another great Friday night fight is underway. Tonight's match is between battling Bruce Brewster and unranked Ricky Wanero. Brewster
waits as Wanero box, please.
Brewster throws 2 foot jabs to Wanero's face. Both those blows were like hammers. That Brewster kid can really hit, and it appears Wanero can take a punch. This fight promises to be another great one. Another left to the head and a long looping right. Brewster down. Listen to this crowd roar.
TV radio fight fans, if you could see this fight, you'd know what the word action means. And now there's a left and a right to a narrow hit.
And Brewster is saved by the bell.
We'll be right back with another round of action-packed World's Eye Championship boxing after this message for Maximus, feminine protection for the incredibly active woman.
Look, dummy, this is a fight. You gotta hit the guy.
Hey, come on, Leon. Don't be negative. I'm wearing him down.
You're wearing me down.
Hey, any cuts?
Any cuts?
At me, you creep.
Oh,
Ow!
He hasn't hit me once. What's the point of this whole thing if he isn't going to hit me?
Maybe he likes you.
Is he? Really?
Cold drink?
You got it.
There's the bell for round two.
Assault fighters are back at it. Toe-to-toe, exchanging blows. This is turning into a real slugfest.
Hit him!
One arrow lands a quick flurry to the body, backing Brewster into the ring. He seems to be cutting off the ring now.
One arrow's body punches seem to lift Brewster right off his feet. Brewster answers to those lightning jabs of his.
And now, there's the...
popcorn!
The left foot and one arrow staggering.
Brewster just standing there, waiting for one arrow to go down on him.
Brewster is saved by the bell.
Hey, creep keeps swinging at me. I'm going to deck him.
That's the idea, dummy.
Hey, come on, Leon. Don't be negative.
He is cute. Would love his pecs.
Promise me one thing.
What? Then,
this next round, you'll hit him.
Where?
Anywhere.
To an arrow's head, and another right, and another hook.
Hit him!
I haven't seen action like this since Dempsey fought Marciano.
This is turning into a real slugfest, fans. Listen to this capacity crowd.
Now another hook, and now a right.
Hey, that sounds like a great fight. Which one is it?
This one.
Huh?
There's a tension in the ring you wouldn't believe. One arrow's eye is blinking, and Brewster's eye is blinking back. And now, it's one arrow with a left and a right to Brewster's stomach. And now Brewster's hanging on.
Yeah! Oh, yeah! Again!
This Brewster kid can really take a punch. In fact, he seems to thrive on it.
Don't stop!
Tickle, bitch.
And one arrow wins the by a knockout. We'll be right back with an interview with the winner.
You're disqualified for hitting after the bell.
What?
Feminine protection for the incredibly active woman.
How's it going? Is it good tonight?
Oh, you almost won, huh?
Yeah. Hey, how's this?
Oh, you know, ups and downs.
Yeah. Hey, night, Gypsy.
Night. Hey, $4.
Okay, you're under arrest. For rape, suspicion of rape, attempted rape, and rape. Freedom is right. Freedom is right.
The right to remain silent. You can give up the right to remain silent.
No, no.
Nothing better to do than to stand around getting stoned.
Shove off, shitbarge.
Hey, now come on, don't be negative.
You bum.
Hey, you know what your problem is?
Oh,
You know what your problem is? You got no dream. Why you so negative?
You sound like Mr. Rogers.
Hey, all right, that's it. Now I'm going to have to get rough.
Oh, you're going to get rough?
Okay. Hey, that's it. Yeah. I'm going to get rough. I'm going to get rough. Hey, you missed.
Hey, Boggs, you did good tonight.
Rex, I heard you fight. You did good.
Yeah, see ya.
You almost won again.
Hey, look. Swat, Bubsy! You got 30 seconds to come out or we're coming in.
You're never gonna take me alive, coppers! I didn't mug that old lady!
Being champ is my dream. And except for Angela, it's all I got. We live together, even though we ain't married. Yet. Angela runs a neighborhood crisis center. But she's so busy helping people that we don't have much time together. Angela stopped coming to my fights. Because, I don't know, I guess watching me fight makes her nervous. I remember when I first saw Angela. I was working as a male stripper at the Peepin' Mary. It was a degrading job, but I just started my boxing lessons, and I needed the money, you know? By just watching a guy take his clothes off, a woman can get a bang out of it. A lot of sex-starved women came to the Peepin' Mary. And not only young women, but women of all ages. When I first saw Angela, I thought she was like all the other women. You know, sex-starved and craving my body. But I was wrong. Angela only came to the club to do research for a class in female psychology. After the show, she asked me to help her with her research. That's how we met.
You just love Jock.
There are very few in-depth, scientifically valid studies of the female response during lovemaking. This should be a very valuable experience. Experiment for science.
I hope you don't mind, but I have to wear these electronic sensors.
Oh, and don't worry about getting shocked or anything like that. It's all low voltage. Oh.
Thank you.
I do appreciate your help.
I don't know, but I guess Angela and me fell in love when I started helping her with her research.
Oh my God.
Hey, Angela?
Nah, it's me, the fumigator.
Hey, you was here yesterday.
Yeah, I'm here every day. This place is roach heaven. Nah, it's not in the bathroom.
Dearest Ricky.
Because my handwriting is so bad, I have decided to type this letter instead.
I realize I have no right
to ask you to give up your dream of becoming champ. But recent developments in my physical anatomy, with their inevitable consequences, make it obvious that sustaining
our connubial relationship can only be detrimental, period. Indeed, devastating to your ability to focus on your already previously stated life objectives. Please.
Try to understand.
I love you.
Oh.
I love you.
Oh.
I love you. Goodbye, Angela. Bye. Angela.
See you tomorrow.
Chicken soup. Be careful, it's very hot. I'll be right back. Everything will be fine. And be careful, it's hot.
Ah, it's hot.
Could you answer that, please?
If it's a crisis, ask them to hold on.
Yeah?
Hi. To whom am I speaking?
Lucky.
Lucky. For only $100, you can buy a share in my rapidly expanding phone call business.
Shove it, you scummy asshole.
Would you like a job?
Asshole.
Could you answer that, please? I'll be right there.
Crisis Center, Angela speaking. How may I help?
Angela.
I'm going to rob you.
What?
Rob.
What?
S-E-X.
Rob.
Could you hold on a second? Crisis Center, Angela speaking. How can I help? Oh, my God. Why does he want to commit suicide? I'll be right there. Where's the key?
Ah!
Ricky, what are you doing here?
Hey, Angela, what's the matter?
I think I lost my car keys.
What's the matter? You don't love me no more, huh?
Of course I love you.
Okay, you love me, I love you. And why are you leaving?
If a person truly loves another person, he never has to ask why.
Okay, I won't ask you why you're leaving. Tell me why I ain't coming back.
I know you, Ricky. You'd give up your dream and you'd take a regular job and you'd be miserable and I'd feel guilty. The only person who'd benefit would be the baby.
Well, babe.
You read my note. I've got a crisis. I've got to go.
Angel, what baby?
I'm pregnant.
Damn garbage can.
Where is he? Has he jumped?
No. He's still up there.
Oh.
Can't make up his mind. I think he's a Libra.
Oh, my God. Mrs. Lucci, call the police.
I did. I called him an hour ago.
Oh.
Shh.
Understand? Stephen! I couldn't get...
Jump already.
Let me go, lady. Telling you, let me go.
If you jump, you'll have to take me with you.
What? Hang on.
Angela was leaving me,
hey,
so
Rick.
I wouldn't give up my dream.
You did good. You almost won.
But yeah, my dream was important. But so was having a baby. I didn't know what to do. I found myself in front of Duffy's bar. I had to talk to someone, and I knew Duffy would listen. Everybody in the neighborhood came to Duffy with their troubles, because Duffy was such a good listener.
Hey, Lucky, how's it going?
Lost my job. My wife's left me. I'm living in the street.
Come on, don't be negative. How'd the fight go?
Good.
Yeah, here you almost won again.
Yeah. Hey, Arnie, what's Duffy?
Hey, Rick. Got a little Valentine suggestion for your girl.
Yeah, what?
Box of dog food in the muzzle.
You better stay in there. That's where you belong, in the toilet, you turd.
Creepy car thief.
Hey, Arnie, come on, what's up? Where else? Listening to trouble. Over there.
She hit me hard.
Look at the jaw.
See the
bruise?
Duffy hit me.
Just look
at these x-rays.
What will you have? The usual? Water? With extra ice?
Yeah.
This is Jim Jones with the human side of sports. I'm here with the heavyweight champ of the world. Champ, what persuaded you to go into the fight game?
I went into fighting because I ain't no fool. I knew I'd get on TV to tell kids to stay in school. Unless you're the champ, fighting sucks.
Champ, if you had it to do all over again, what would you do?
If I had it to do all over again, I'd do it all over you.
This is Jim Jones.
Hey, the champ is greatest. He's a bum. You calling the champ a bum? Yeah.
Champ's right. What happens to kids is important. What would the world be like without kids?
Terrible.
Now, what do you know about kids?
Hey, I know about kids. I got one.
You want him, you got him. And I'll even throw in his bong and his girlfriend. She looks like a poster girl for a VD clinic.
Hey, come on, don't be negative. Kids is all right. It's just the way you raise them.
Hey, I know how to raise them. With this.
They're all the same.
Yeah, well, mine's not gonna be the same. Oh, you'll see, pal. No, you'll see. That's your trouble. You're negative. That's why you got bongs and VD clinics.
What?
Oh, Duffy, I made up my mind.
What?
Forget the water.
Next morning, I headed to Vinny's gym. I knew what I had to do. Vinny's gym was like my second home, where I learned to fight. All my friends were there. Oh, it was Leon and Frenchie and Pepino.
Hey.
All the guys.
Hey, Vinny. Come on, it could be Ricky. Come to my fights, remember?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I didn't recognize you standing up.
Yeah. Hey, listen, give my best to the champ, huh? The champ's the greatest.
Is it true what they say that the champ's dumping you?
No comment.
Is it true what they say that you work for the mob?
Is it true that all the champs fight for fish? No comment.
Is it true that the town is trying to kill you?
Is it true what they say about Billy Jean?
Is it true what they say about Liberace?
Is it true what they say about Oscar Wilde?
No comment.
Is it true what they say about San Francisco?
No comment.
Is it true what they say about Dixie?
No comment.
No comment.
Come on, Vinny. Hey, Vinny, just one more. Okay, Vinny, one more question.
Hey, where's my mirror?
Hey, Pacino. Listen, I'm quitting boxing. I'm gonna miss you. Hey, Rick. Hey, Frenchie. Hey, listen, I decided to give up fighting. I'm gonna miss you. Give me Rick. Hey, Leon.
What?
Give me Rick. Well,
at least you know your name, dummy.
Hey, listen, Leon. Decided to take a regular job. Quitting boxing.
Good. You're a bum and a loser.
Well, hey, come on. Don't be negative.
How many fights I get you?
15.
How many you almost win?
15.
Do me a favor.
Sure.
Don't let the door hit you in the ass on the way out.
Oh, yeah, thanks. Hey, listen, I'm gonna buy lunch sometime, huh?
Yeah. Sure.
See ya.
See ya.
Oh. Hey, guys. Hey, it's me, Rick. Listen, I'm quitting fighting. I'm gonna miss you. All of you. See ya.
Sure tough saying goodbye to old friends.
Go on, come in.
Rumors continue to persist that the heavyweight champ of the world will dump Benny Domino.
What are we gonna do if the champ dumps you, boss?
Forget it. The bum's got nowhere to go.
Keep looking.
Keep your eyes open.
You guys see anything that looks like a tong or even sounds like a tong? Kill it.
Right, boss.
Crisis Center, Angela speaking. I'll be right there.
Hey, Angela.
Ricky, there's a crisis. I've got to go.
No, wait, listen. I made up my mind. No more fighting. That's a promise.
But what about your dream?
Yeah, well, being champ isn't as important as you and the baby.
You sure?
Yeah, I'm sure. Promise is a promise. Okay? So now we're back together again, you, me, and the baby, huh? Just the two of us. Oh. Hey, come on, don't cry. Let me see you there.
Oh, Ricky. I love you.
Yeah, me too. Don't worry about no bongs and no VD clinics, huh?
I started looking in the paper for a job. I couldn't figure out what I wanted to do. And then I remembered an ad I'd seen on TV for one of them guidance places. You know, where you take a test. I didn't like tests, and it was expensive, but I figured it was like being in boxing, you know? When you really need help, the only thing to do is talk to a pro.
Mr. Monero, I have your test results.
Ah,
I'm Dr. Furskin.
Yeah, hey, listen, Dr. Furskin, Yeah, hey, look, Doc, the only reason I took your test is because your lady said I couldn't fail, you know? Look, Doc, I know what I want to do, but what I want to do isn't what I should do, so I don't know. What should I do, Doc?
Well, based on your test results, Mr. Monero, I don't know. Mr. Monero, what is it that you think you should do?
I don't know. Take a job?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yes, any job.
Yeah. Any job, right?
Yes, as soon as you can.
As soon as I can. Yeah. Yeah. Take a regular job. Yeah.
Is there anything more I can do to help?
I don't know. Hey.
Good luck.
Hey, thanks, Doc. Thank you. Take a regular job.
It took me a couple of weeks, but I finally found the job as an executive management trainee at a fish market. The place smelled, but I kind of liked it. It reminded me of being back at the gym. Well, the worst part were the fish eyes staring at me while I chopped their heads off. Angela was still busy running the crisis center and happy I had a regular job.
Hey, hold on. Quiet!
Mr. Champ has a brief statement to make. Then he'll answer all your questions.
Well, I am the champ, and the champ ain't no slob. That's why I'm dumping Vinny and the mob. I'm gonna promote my own fights and be all the best. And when I'm rich, I retire and rest. Right, so Captain. Goodbye, Vinny and all them mob bums. The Silver Shadows taking the A-train. Out for the slums.
Yeah. This is Jim Jones with the Evening Sports. In football, more than $400,000 will be spent painting the stadium of the San Francisco Gays of bright lavender. Match their uniforms. Some late baseball scores, 6-4, and in the nightcap.
So, you like your job, huh?
In the National League, rain has delayed the start of the twilight doubleheader between the Dodgers and the Reds. But the big news in sports today
is the
long-awaited announcement by the heavyweight champ.
Green beans, mashed potatoes, rolls,
with Vinny Domino.
And a surprise.
Rumors of the impending break have been circulating for weeks, and today at a press conference,
okay, hold on.
I made us a special candlelight dinner. With wine.
Huh?
That's why I'm dumping this video. I'm gonna promote my own fight.
So, you like your job, huh? Job. You like it, huh?
Yeah.
Really like it?
Yeah, it's good. Hey.
This chance is greatest.
I said that. Who's the true that's fighting sucks unless you're the champ?
I said that.
And champ, the truth is you're hung like a lord.
Yay, the champ is number one.
The champ further indicated that he will soon be announcing his new opponent.
I knew it. You hate your job. I'm so sorry that I made you give up your dream to work in a fish market. The potatoes are burned.
Hey, come on. I like burnt potatoes.
I feel so guilty.
Hey, it's okay. Besides, I got a new dream. Oh, yeah. I figure, hey, a year or so, I want my own fish market. Huh?
Is that what you really want?
Yeah. Hey.
Rick, I love you so much. Promise me you'll never leave me.
Yeah, I promise. Hey, I'm hungry.
Hello? Huh? What? Before it gets cold.
And what about you?
Well, I'll have to get out.
Busy helping people and getting more pregnant. The baby was getting bigger, and so were the doctor bills. And I didn't want Angela worrying about bills because of her condition, you know? Vinny said he'd loan me some money, but only if I'd work for him on my lunch hour. Yeah, I knew it was wrong, but I didn't want Angela worrying, and we needed the money. I figured I'd work a few lunch hours, pay off the doctor bills, and quit. Doctors are expensive. That's probably why they become doctors, so they can afford to go to doctors.
That's you, Gypsy.
Come on in.
Well, working as a gigolo is even more degrading than working at the Peeping Mary.
I hear you're the greatest. For 50 bucks, you better be. I understand the prophylactic, but what's with the earmuffs and the nose clip?
Oh, that's because there's two things I can't stand, and that's the sound of a screaming woman and the smell of burnt rubber.
Welcome to tonight's Crisis Center lecture on home burglary prevention. Home burglary in this neighborhood could become a problem. Psychologists tell us that in extreme cases of home burglaries, the victims can actually become paranoid. Well, what can we do to protect ourselves? Well, I have invited here tonight the president of Home Security Systems, Inc. to come here and give us some suggestions. Let's hear it for Mr. George C. Patton. Patton.
At ease. Now, maybe some of you poor bastards don't know it, but there's a war going on out there. There's the burglars, and then there's us. And so far, we're getting our butts kicked. And don't let any mealy-mouthed liberal bastard tell you otherwise. I don't know about you, but if there's one thing in life I hate, it's burglars. I also hate hemorrhoid commercials for personal reasons, but that's not important. What is important is winning the war against burglars. And this is the baby that's going to do it. This is our model 666. Pressure-sensitive landmine made to look like a welcome mat. Stick this baby outside your door, a burglar shows up, boom! Instant justice for only $14.95. No credit cards or CODs. Now, for your windows, we got this here exploding window shade. Now, this baby will blow the ass out of a battleship. Imagine what it'll do to a burglar for only $13.95, no credit cards or CODs. Now, I'd like to demonstrate the welcome mat. I need a volunteer. Hey. Hey, where you going? Hey, come back here, you mealy-mouthed liberal creeps. I'll show you. You mealy-mouthed cowards.
Angela and the baby were okay, but the explosion wrecked the crisis center. And Angela had no place where she could help people. You could see she was real sad. She never said nothing. I felt terrible. Well, I got Vinny to say he was donating money to fix the place up. But it was only a loan.
Where's the money?
Oh. $200 from the lady on Park Avenue.
What's this?
Oh, that's a check from the lady on Sutton Place. She got home late from a church bazaar.
Yeah, you don't listen too good, do you? If I was taking checks, I'd be chasing every deadbeat broad in town. You want to work for me? Well, do what I tell you. Cash only. Here, you take the check.
Okay.
Good. Right. Now, look, I got three more for you. This is a lady here on First Avenue. She wants you to do a Spanish dance on her stomach.
Spanish dance?
Like bolero.
Bolero on her stomach. Yeah.
Oh, you sure she signs this release before you start?
Sign release. Okay.
She's got a bad ticker. This one's in Park Village. Now get yourself a plastic sheet, some olive oil, and a baseball bat. She'll tell you what to do.
Plastic sheet.
Oh, on the ground, boy. if she don't have a Spanish record, you know, just hum something.
Hum.
And treat her nice.
Okay. Treat her nice, yeah.
Okay. Okay. Hey. Hey, you getting enough sleep? Look tired.
Yeah. I'm in sleep.
That was your girl, with Angela.
Angela.
Good.
Yeah.
Good. Hey, I told you. You'll love her.
Yeah.
Hey, come on. Drop you by the fish market.
All right, thanks.
Oh, I almost forgot the third broad. It's that sandpaper broad, the one with a wooden leg. She called me. She wants coarser sandpaper. Okay?
Now, you listen, Sugar Joe. You got a chance here to fight the champ. Me. More money than your brain can count. And the mob gets nothing, baby. Now, all you got to do is say yes.
You mean you have your girl get back to my girl? Don't you hang up on me, man. Nobody hangs up on a champ, you hear me? Nobody. You hear me? You hear me?
I guess he didn't hear you.
Shut up. Look, all that. They're all going back.
Look, man. They're all scared. Nobody's going to call.
Word's out.
Shut up.
Face it, man. The mob shut us out.
Shut up. Nobody shuts me out. I'm numero uno, baby.
I'm hungry.
Shut up.
And all you can say is shut up.
Shut up. They're going to call. The phone's going to be ringing off the hook.
If we go out and get something to eat, maybe you can find somebody at the restaurant to find.
Everybody stays here till that phone rings. Mother, you hear me? Stick it!
That's bad grammar. Take an enema.
How would you like a bust in the mouth?
Yeah.
Hey, here's somebody on TV you could fight. He's from South America. He calls himself the Bolivian Bomber.
What'd they say? What about him?
He's won all 46 of his fights. 36 by death. He'll probably kill you.
Yeah. Ain't no mob down there. All they got is them That's it.
Extra, extra, bomber arrives to fight camp. Extra, extra, Polish toilet explodes, hundreds homeless.
King's College 64.
Hey, boss, what are we going to do about this Bolivian bomber?
Hey, it's not what we're going to do, it's what I'm going to do. And I'm going to tell you what I'm going to do.
Godfather, boss.
Don Morleone. Yeah. Well, it's exactly what I was going to do.
Hey, well, I'll do that, too. And may your health be the health of all men.
Nobody tells Vinny Domino what to do. Nobody.
What, boss?
Shut up. Don Morleone, Godfather. Sounds like an appetizer.
Here's to the bomber. He's come to fight. The punches will fly. It'll be quite a sight. We'll all make some dough, because the people want to see what happens in the ring to the bomber and me. So here's to the bomber and his manager, Adolfo.
Crisis center was all fixed up, and Angela was back helping people. But to pay Vinny back,
Rich?
I was working for him nights and lunch hours. But it was worth it, seeing Angela happy again.
Oh, Rick, I can't give up my work. I know it seems like every time we get together, I'm always crying.
Yeah.
But the doctor says that I have to take vitamin supplements or give up my work. He says I look tired.
Yeah?
And these vitamin supplements cost $400, and I don't know if we can afford them.
Yeah.
I'll be right there. I love you, Rick. But I'll be right back.
Great.
think it's one of those tongs, boss.
Now listen, you fortune cookie freak. You tongs, stop muscling into my territory or you're dead. This town belongs to me, Vinny Domino, and I'll kill every one of you sweet and sour creeps. I speak American. Vinny Domino, what to do? I tell you, nobody.
Shanghai sucks.
I told you, right head.
Where are we gonna find a loser, boss?
I'm surrounded by him.
Maybe he's dead, boss.
He's not that smart.
Hey, Lover!
Hey, come on, don't be negative.
Hey, you're working too hard.
No, hey, I was just meditating.
Got another job for you. A real job. You're gonna make some real dough.
Yeah? Sure, what?
It's a chance of a lifetime. It's a contract. You're gonna fight the champ.
Me fight the champ?
That's what I said.
Hey, come on. Champ's the greatest.
Well, beat him, and you're gonna be the greatest.
I can't beat the champ.
Why?
He's the champ.
Oh. What's the matter? You scared?
No, I ain't scared.
Then you're gonna fight him.
I can't.
What do you mean you can't?
I promised to give up boxing.
What?
I promised Angela I'd give up boxing for the baby.
You gotta be crazy.
Promise is a promise.
Promise is a promise. I got another job for you. Okay, lady from the west side.
West side.
She wants you to look like a rabbit. Bring some carrots.
Carrots.
And when you leave, punch her in the mouth hard.
Punch her in the mouth hard.
I want you to continue thinking about fighting the champ. Because who knows, you know, maybe something will happen, make you change your mind. Things happen.
Yeah. Things happen, yeah. Hey, give my best to the champ, huh?
I want you to keep thinking about it!
Yeah. You fight the champ. You fight the champ. We fight the champ. Promise is a promise.
A promise is a promise. I offer this bum a chance to fight the champ, and what does he do? Turns me down.
What are you gonna do, boss?
Nobody turns Vinny Domino down. What am I gonna do? It's not what I'm gonna do, it's what you're gonna do. Without a promise, see? There's no promise, right? You take care of that Angela broad tonight, while the rabbit's out hopping.
Who's there? Who's there? Oh, it's you. Did you bring the carrots? Come in.
Here, Mr. Smith, some chicken soup.
Oh, bless you. I love chicken soup.
Be careful, it's very hot.
Thank you.
Thank you.
killing, don't you? It's a living.
Can't you just go home and apologize to your wife?
If I go home, she'll beat me. She says I'm always criticizing her.
Do you have any money?
No.
Do you have a job?
I lost my job. I worked for a TV station. I was a critic. The station manager fired me.
Why?
Said I was too critical.
Tell her it's a crisis.
Oh, help me. Help me. Crisis
Center, Angela speaking. How can I help?
I can't help it. It's my nature to be critical.
Oh, my God. I'll be right there.
What about me?
Just drink your soup.
She's coming out.
Soup tastes like urine.
Oh, where are those darn car keys? I don't have time for this. God, I must have left them in the bathroom.
It's that creepy car thief. Hey!
Angela, I'm going to rob you.
Bad karma.
Angela thought her car blew up because she used cheap gas. And I didn't say nothing, because I didn't want to scare her. Vinny was right. Things happen, especially if Vinny wants them to. And I figured more things would happen if I didn't agree to fight the champ. Yeah, a promise is a promise. But without Angela, it don't mean nothing. She probably wouldn't have believed what Vinny done anyway. She don't want to believe people can be bad.
I'm taking a page from the champ's book. I'm here to put your rumors to rest about troubles between me and the champ, because he's the best. I'm glad to say we're together again, and he ain't going to leave till I say when. Just kidding, I love him. He's a beautiful guy. Now, I'd like to introduce his next worthy opponent, Ricky One Arrow. Ricky, come
Ricky
on up here.
Ricky, who?
The expansion of the basketball season means they'll be playing 12 months a year. Good news for basketball fans. Well, at a very crowded press conference earlier today, the big news in sports was the announcement by Vinny Domino, the heavyweight champ's next opponent, a total unknown by the name of Ricky. All the new young hopeful had to say about the upcoming fight was this.
Do you think you can beat the champ?
Oh, hey, champ. It's great.
In a recent editorial, this radio station, KVVD, said the only solution to overcrowding in our nation's prisons was to raise taxes and build more prisons. Well, as a taxpayer, I vigorously disagree. Now, there are two practical things we can do right now at no expense to reduce prison population. First, for criminals serving 15 years or less, we got the Swim for Freedom contest. That's once a year on the 4th of July, the prisoners would line up on a beach in Atlantic City. When the guards start shooting, they'd start swimming toward Bermuda. Now, the winner would get to go free, and a runner-up gets to be an alternate on the Olympic swim team. Now, for convicted killers, we got a TV game show called the 50,000 Volt Question. It's six killers competing to see which one lives. The winner would be set free in a South American jungle of his choice with the promise that he won't come back. Now, remember, building things don't solve nothing. 4,000 years ago, them chinks sank a bundle into that Great Wall of China. And what do they got today? Nothing but a broken-down 3,000-mile room divider.
That was Leon Luger, a member of the Downtown Taxpayers Association, speaking in response to a recent KVVD editorial. And now, a selection.
Wait. I gotta talk to you.
About what?
You're gonna need a manager.
Yeah, why you want to manage a bum and a loser?
Okay, I called you a bum and a loser. You wanna know why?
Yeah, I wanna know why.
I'll tell you why. Because you got a lot of talent, but you got no hate. You gotta have hate if you want to be a winner. That was my problem.
Yeah.
We're a lot alike, you and me. We're both too good, too moral.
I got
Maycoat.
What? I got Maycoat.
Huh?
I got Maycoat.
Shut up.
When are you gonna visit us
gonna go to the playground.
Yes, you do. I'm Captain Raincoat, and I come to say when you stop running, keep your legs in the way.
Come on, get out of here.
Yep.
Yeah? I could have been somebody. I could have been Champ. Remember the night you came to my locker room and told me I had to take a dive? Could have been Champ. Could have beat her. Could have had some class. Instead, what am I? A bum in a dirty raincoat in an alley. You should have looked out for me. You're my brother.
Hey, Leon, I'm not your brother.
You know?
I'm Captain Raincoat, and I've come to say, when I flap my wings,
I
keep the witches away.
You little snitches. You never saw any witches, did you?
Here's the office. Crisis Center, Angela speaking. Oh. Mrs. Cornet, hi. Yeah, I got you the groceries. I'll be right there. I had to stop and get some aspirin for someone. The crackers? Yeah, curly noodle, that's all they had. I know you're hungry. I'll be right there. Okay. Yeah, goodbye. Bye. Lucky, take the aspirin. You'll feel the difference in a moment. I'll be right back. There's nothing to talk about. I can't talk. No.
Angela wouldn't talk to me because I'd broken my promise.
Help!
And I couldn't tell her why. I didn't want to scare her.
Help!
I was supposed to be training, but I couldn't keep my mind on it. I started thinking about Leon. Maybe if I hired him, it would help.
Are you listening to me? Now you get your punch power from your upper body. Understand? We gotta build up your upper body strength, so lift. Lift, come on.
To thank you guys for volunteering to help your wives in tonight's rape prevention class. Let's hear it for the guys. Our guest speaker tonight is Officer Leroy Bonner.
Boner.
Oh. Officer Boner is a dedicated and a unique police officer.
2 years ago, in an effort to stop the increasing number of rapes in our neighborhood, he volunteered to become a female decoy. And he's been attacked so many times, he doesn't even care to talk about it. Actually, 70.
69.
Tonight, he will be showing us defense techniques for a typical rooftop assault where a woman is attacked while sunning herself. His face will be disguised to ensure the continued effectiveness of himself as a female decoy. Let's hear it for Officer Boner.
Now, ladies, here is your first step in repelling an attack. These two fingers.
I think I'm for gay rights.
Okay, ladies, let's try it with your husband. Step one. Fingers in the eye.
Look, I don't want to interrupt the crisis or nothing, but,
there is no crisis. It's just a lecture.
Look, you got to understand there's a lot of things you don't understand, and...
All I can understand is that you love your dream of being champ more than you love me and the baby, or else you wouldn't have broken your promise.
And I'll tell you why. You want to know why? You want to know why? I'm going to tell you why. Because I love you. That's why.
And I love you. But now you have your dream, and I'll have the baby.
I can't eat, I can't sleep. What good's having a dream? You can't sleep.
Mickey, I realize it's hard on you, but it's hard on me,
that's
too.
That's it. You're getting it, lady.
Oh, my God.
What's the matter?
Oh, my God.
What's the matter?
I'm having the baby. I'm having the baby.
Don't get to the first baby. Good.
Paging Dr. Black.
I think it's my rectum again, Doctor. Well, let's take a look. Ow!
Dr. Black.
Excuse me, nurse.
Excuse me, nurse. Is there any word yet about my mother?
Relax, Mr. Jones. Your mother will be fine. Just sit down.
Hi. I'm looking for my girl, Angela. You know, she just had a baby.
So? Station 5.
To whom am I speaking?
What do you want?
Attention. Attention. All relatives whose mothers are alive in the hospital, please stand up. Not so fast, Mr. Jones. Paging Dr. Green.
You'll have to call information. The phones are down the hall.
Down the hall. Thanks.
And how come you didn't say anything about my mustache?
Oh, hey, looks good.
Paging Dr. Black. Paging Dr. White. Paging Dr. White.
Dr. White.
Paging Dr. Black.
Dr. Black.
Paging Dr. Green.
Dr. Green.
Dr. Green.
Well, you didn't catch it from me.
A rose? What's a rose doing up there?
Read the card, silly.
Fight. Yeah, if I fight the champ, we'll have enough dough to pay the bill. Then I can quit fighting. It'll
good. No more dreaming.
Meg, the champ will kill you.
Hey, come on. Besides, I'm a fast healer.
Meg, promise me one thing. Promise me you won't make any more promises you'll break.
Yeah. And it's a promise. Huh? Hey, Mr. Rose, meet my girlfriend, Angela. Hi, Angela. I'm Mr. Foot. I'm Mr. Plant.
I love you. The baby loves you, too.
Yeah, me too. I mean, I love you, too. Both of you. Hey, boy or girl?
They won't say till we pay.
$400 for Q-tips, huh?
Rhythm. Oh, where you going?
Huh? What's the matter?
I don't know. Guess my rhythm's off.
You have to wear those crummy gloves. Here, wear this.
What is it?
Wear it. It'll help.
Benny, go here!
No comment!
Beans. Come on, guy, eat all these beans.
Beans is carbohydrates, dummy. Instant energy. You're gonna need it. Eat. It's called stuffing. Eat.
I'm a cramp.
Why?
I'm stuffed.
Where you going?
I gotta go to the bathroom.
It will make it fast. And save that energy.
Yeah.
Let's go. Time to dance.
This way.
Well,
yes, Howard. Agree with that, but as far as I'm concerned, this match is a smash.
Well, sure, the champ is overweight and undertrained, but his punches are still devastating. I would be surprised if he tore one arrow's head off in the first round.
Not this way. You'd get lost in a closet. To him, dummy.
Hey, champ sure is popular, huh?
Yeah. So's herpes.
Who knows what evil lurks in the punches of men? The shadow knows!
You sure got a good sense of humor, huh?
Get more laughs from watching cement dry.
Hi, Captain Raincoat.
Come on, get out of here, you little creeps.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to tonight's fight. 15 rounds of boxing for the heavyweight championship of the world. And on my right, the challenger, known to his fans as Super Stud Ricky Juanero. And on my left, the undisputed heavyweight champion of the world, known to his beloved fans as the Silver Shadow.
Okay, yo, champ. Yeah. Champ, could I get your autograph for my girl? Okay, I'll get it later.
Okay, you both know the rules. There'll be no hitting below the belt. In the event of a knockdown, the knockee must go to a neutral corner. Each round is scored on a 10-point must system, which means you must have a system in order to score a point. And when the bell rings, I want you to both come out wearing deodorant, and there'll be no smoking in the ring. Good luck.
Yeah, good luck.
Go to your corner.
Good evening, fight fans. This is Ringside Radio as another exciting world's eye view of championship boxing is about to get underway.
He's done in one.
He's trained on beer and pizza. All you got to do is wear the bum down.
Hey, come on. It's a champ.
You're fighting, not marrying.
Go slow out there, man. You know, shit to fight. Maybe two.
And with me tonight is my colleague on Ringside Radio, Paul Fingers, who will be describing tonight's action for our hearing-impaired listeners. Paul, how does tonight's championship fight shape up for you?
Stay loose out there. Just bob and weave. Keep moving. Save your punches. Let him wear himself down.
When do I hit him?
Not until I say so.
In the name of the Father and of the Son,
I'll pray for you.
There's the bell for round one. Another great championship bout is coming our way. Both fighters come to the center of the ring, slowly circling one another, bobbing and weaving, looking for an opening. Both fighters are still circling one another, bobbing and weaving. One narrow is bobbing, and the champ is weaving.
Now the champ throws a hard left jab to one narrow's head, and another.
Wait a minute.
Now a right cross to a narrow's head. Hit a left hook. Another cross. Another hook.
Good.
There's a jab to a narrow's head. One narrow misses with a right cross. And now a right cross. Another left hook. He seems to be concentrating on one narrow's head. There's another left hook. And another right cross. Another hook. Another cross. And now... David... We'll be right back with another World's Eye View of championship boxing after this message for Preparation O. Remember, Preparation O is the only hemorrhoid ointment you can also use to wax your car.
Any cut?
Oh!
Tough still, I'll hurt you.
Let him wear himself out. Hold your punches.
Here's the bell for round two, Radio Fight fans, as both fighters are out into the center of the ring, slowly circling one another, bobbing and weaving, looking for an opening. The champ seems to be able to anticipate every move that Juan Nero makes. I don't know how he does it.
How's he doing?
Get some mouthwash, will you?
Juan Nero is staggering, and the champ throws another left hook and another right cross. Another left hook and another right cross. Those glass boots blows were like hammers. Juan Nero throws a vicious strike, and Juan Nero is down.
Ricky Juanero has the rad bod, but I don't know, he fights like a full-on geek. Why'd you bring me here, dummy?
For inspiration, dear.
Inspiration for what, stupid?
Another cut, and Juanero's down!
This.
One, two, three!
Man, that honky's head is made of cement.
Come on, man. Some of my best friends are honkies.
How do you feel?
Good, good. From here down.
Suck this.
And another right cross, and another left hook, and another right, and another left, and a vicious right. I can feel long throws from here.
Yes, I agree.
Hit him.
This Juanero kid certainly can take a punch.
Hit him.
No, not you.
And there's the another left and right coming.
The champ is taking the shit out of him.
Hit him.
I'll let you know.
A couple more rounds like that, he'll drop from exhaustion.
I haven't seen action like this since Dempsey fought Sugar Ray Leonard. There's another left.
Where are you now?
Another right. And another right cross. And another left.
That's it. Good.
It's amazing to me that Juan Nero's still on his feet. I'll say this for Juan Nero. He's all heart. And now the champ of the mission. And Juan Nero wins.
I think I broke my hand.
There's another left and another right.
Hey, cuts, don't touch me, you creep. I didn't hurt you.
Champ's arms seem to be tiring, but his punches still have some mustard on them.
Who's that mayonnaise? In the stomach. You better go for the stomach, man. You're running out of things to hit him with.
You got him. He's exhausted. All you got to do now is finish him off.
This fight on his feet, it'll be a miracle. There's a left and a right to Juan Nero's stomach. The champ seems to have shifted his attack to Juan Nero's stomach. Paul, what's your reaction? Another right, and now a left, as Juan Nero hangs on.
Oh, well, this is too much.
And Juan Nero is down! Again.
If Ricky Juanero can sink this three-foot putt, he's won the British Open. And now his caddy steps back and hits him with a left hook. It all seems so senseless.
Juanero is saved by the bell. We'll be right back after this word from Preparation O, the only hemorrhoid ointment you can also use to wax your car.
You gotta cut me. I can't see him.
Cut him. Not his wrist, dummy.
What?
His eye. Never mind. Forget it.
You gotta cut me. I can't find him.
Don't worry. He'll find you.
Oh, awesome.
This way. Come on. Out that way.
The champ throws another right thrust to Winero's head.
Okay, quick!
When Narrow's head. Narrow's down.
Go to your corner. Go to your corner.
When Narrow, blind in one eye, groping around the ring, looking for the champ. I haven't seen a display of guts and courage like this since Dempsey fought Cosell. And now, a right by Winero to the champ's stomach. And now a left, and a right, and another left, and another right, another left, and another right. The champ is staggering.
And the champ is down.
Okay.